But I would just sit and try to figure out my formula with it. And just figure out a way that I could make it work for me. I didn't know what some of the things meant, the words, quantize, transpose. I didn't know what any of it meant. I just knew when you press this button, it does that. And I made that work for me. My process, I basically get up very early. I don't like sleep. I try to get sleep out of the way. Like when I'm working, if I feel like I'm starting to get tired, I get mad. I genuinely get upset, like, fuck. I just want to keep working. I wish I could just never sleep. I'm a hunter. In this world, you have gatherers and you have hunters. I'm a hunter. We're all looking for that one record that's the greatest record on the planet of Earth. We never find it, but that's, I guess, the whole idea. Keep hunting. Usually have like a nice checklist in my head as I'm looking at the records. A naked girl on the cover is instant buy. Always. Naked women cover. Fire. 100%. Sometimes I'm listening to records in the store and I'm feeling the inspiration and I'm hearing things on records that I'm like. Then I go home, put the records back on in a different environment. The records don't sound the same anymore. Sometimes I wish I just had the drum machine right there sitting next to me in the record store. You know, a record should give you an idea. It should spark you. It's source material. You know? I'm doing work. This is my source material. My production style is probably well described as scatterbrain. I never know. I like the mystery of grabbing a bunch of things and samples and not knowing where it's going to go. So usually what I'm starting with and what I finish with is just completely different. You gotta do the same thing over and over till you really get a technique or become precise. But really, there really is no method to the madness. I try to get inspiration, try to reach for some inspiration that's beyond me. Like, I just try to be the circuit, the conduit, where the energy travels through. So I'll, you know, kind of reach up for some energy that will go through me, because it's gotta be bigger than me. Whatever I'm going to make has to be somehow something more than what I could have created just as a mortal human being. How do you finish a beat? When do you say, all right, this is it. That's it. The beat is done. I mean, to me, that's the hardest part, is how to let go and pull the trigger. There's nothing worse than an overcooked meal. You know, something with too much flavor. You can actually have too much flavor. Like, just every fucking spice dumped into the pot. What is this? You know? And I think, you know, with all the options when you work on music now, it's possible to just free fall down the rabbit hole of endless possibilities. People always ask me what machine I use, and it's like, whatever. Just make it sing. You know, when I came up, I started, it was all ASR-10. And I used to sit with the ASR-10 and just try to master it. And I, to this day, still, there's things in the ASR-10 that I don't know about, because I kind of found my way with it and just started cooking. I never looked at myself as like a drum guy, but I feel like there were a bunch of sounds that I used over the years that kind of gave you a feel for what I was going for with the way the snare might have sounded or the kicks. And so the idea was to go back to the old discs, the floppy discs, the zips, went back to the ASR-10, and I just loaded up all the old beats, soloed the drums, and giving them to the people. My friends don't call me. They don't call me. You just show up. You show up 6:30 in the morning, bang on the door. That's how I work. I can remember the day that I made the beat for We Gonna Make It. I had it up on the ASR-10 and DJ Premier came by my crib. I was afraid to play it for him because I used a clap instead of a snare. I said, you know what, fuck it, I'll just play it anyways. He came up, I played it for him, and he was like, yeah, I like this, man, I can rap to it. The Ensoniq ASR-10 is like the good, trusty old pal, you know, always comes through. It's got its quirks, you know, it'll shuffle some data, you know, it might error reboot, something like that, but in the end, we always made it work. Being safe is whack. That's like a false sense of security. Like, oh, okay, this is safe, this will work. Safe is corny. Never be afraid to save a beat and move on to the next one. Never be afraid to erase a beat. Does this track, did you make the track or did the track make you? That's a good question you gotta ask yourself. We hold on to things that are great that we created sometimes, and it could stunt our growth. You know, as if that one beat or that one verse makes you. Music is therapy, it's spiritual, way beyond something that I could even put words to, like it's something that I probably need.